Okay, dear student, this is the first video lecture, right? And here we will proceed from our last session where we have discussed about QTs. So in today's video lecture we are going to learn about triplicate and duplicate system of controlling. If in case you remember that what we have learned in the last session was QTs and different types of QTs, COR, supplement, accident, return or replace. So all these QTs we have covered in the last session. It was on 24th of March 2020. Now we are going for the checking system, and we will learn about two checking system, that is triplicate and duplicate. So we will start with the triplicate checking system, because this triplicate checking system is the most important system which is being used. This system is used in majority of medium and large establishment. The food ordered is recorded in three copies and each copy has same serial number. So as you know that we, for the QTs, that is kitchen order ticket, we have three copies and the serial number of each and every copy remains the same. These copies may be clearly marked as 1, 2 and 3, or it is also known as control copy, the first copy, account copy, the second copy, and book copy, the third copy. So it has to be marked either 1, 2 or 3, or as a control copy, account copy, and book copy. To differentiate further between these copies, all these copies should have a different color. This is to ensure that it is easy for identification purpose. To ensure, order taker must follow the information required at the top of QT's carbon sheet. So you have a carbon sheet so that same order is written in all the three QTs, and as we have already discussed and we have seen a format of kitchen order ticket, we have table number, we have date and time, we have number of covers, we have waiter name and code, and signature of waiter taking the order. So all these information you have already seen in the last session when I have displayed a QT format to you. So if in case we write it in the first copy, it automatically gets into the second and third copy because we are using a carbon sheet. So how this system works? The food order is written in triplicate without any correction and should be signed by order taker. Now why it is important that there should be no correction? Because if in case you do some correction, it means that there are chances of some malpractices. So it is important that there should be no correction when you are making a QT. Right? Then in case of resident guest, his or her room number should be written clearly. So if in case there is some in-house guest, he will not pay you the cash. So you have to clearly mention the room number so that the cashier can post that amount into the folio of the resident guest. So this is for the resident guest, that a room number is a must. The first copy is for food order, which is normally white in color, is taken to the kitchen and handed over to the abhoyer. Abhoyer, you know, is a barker who shouts the order. The first copy is a kitchen copy. So it goes to the kitchen, or you give it to abhoyer or barker, and he barks the order, he shouts the order. Nowadays, the waiter or the steward themselves pass the order and tell the order to the kitchen staff. So the first copy, where you have written the order, goes to the kitchen. After executing all the dishes mentioned in the QT, the abhoyer inserts it through the slot of a locked box. So there is a box kept in the kitchen where the abhoyer keeps all the QT which he gets after all the order which is mentioned in the QT has been given to the steward. So the first process is that the waiter takes the order in the QT. Now the first copy of the order goes to the kitchen. It is given to the abhoyer or barker, or the steward themselves barks the order. After all the dishes has been taken by the steward, served to the guest, this particular QT is inserted into a lock box by the abhoyer or by any other staff which have been assigned this duty in the kitchen. The duplicate copy, or the second copy, which may be of any color other than white, goes to the cashier who makes out the guest bill referring to the KOT serial number. Now the second copy is given to the cashier. With the help of the KOTs and the item mentioned in the KOT, it is the cashier who makes the bill where he specifically mentioned the serial number of the KOT. So it is easy to match that which KOT has which bill to it. KOT number should be written on the bill. It is important so that we can match that the bill is of which particular KOT. The billing clerk ensures that all the dishes entered in KOT are charged and correctly calculated. I have already mentioned that undercharging or overcharging both are wrong. So this is the responsibility of the cashier or the billing clerk to ensure that all the items which are mentioned in the KOTs are billed and is charged from the guest. Room number of the guest, if residential guest is served, should be entered and the bill should be signed by the billing clerk. So if in case the guest who is taking the meal is an in-house guest, the room number should be specifically mentioned and the clerk should post the amount into the folio of the guest. So once he posts the amount, it will automatically reflect it into the folio of the guest. The third copy, which may be of any color other than the one chosen for the first two copies, is retained by the waiter at his or her sideboard as a mean of reference during service. So the last copy, which is also known as thin copy or flimsy copy, it remains into the waiter's KOT book. So this is, with the help of this particular KOT, the last KOT, it acts as a reference point. So if in case there is some doubt in the mind of auditor that there is some problem in the KOT and the bill, the order placed, so this act as a reference for the auditor. So during service, any cancellation or correction on KOT, if in case, first of all, it should be avoided. But if in case there is certain, then you have to ensure it has a signature of the head waiter or the supervisor. Right. So the first thing is that you should not have any cancellation, you should not have any scribbling on the KOTs. But if in case it is there, you have to make sure that your KOT is countersigned by the head waiter or supervisor to ensure it is genuine and it's not the fake one. To understand the summary of this triplicate system, let's go through this chart, which also includes the BOT, that is beverage order ticket. So this is our food and beverage service area. You can see this is a food and beverage service area. So the top copy or the first copy, it goes to the kitchen, right? So it goes to the kitchen. So from here you take the food item, the steward takes the food item, and it is being served at the F&B service area, that is the restaurant. This is clear. Now from the kitchen, as I told you, that the first copy after the service goes to a control box. This is a control box. So after the service has been done in the restaurant, this particular copy goes to the control box. From the control box, this top copy goes to the auditor for the control purpose. Now the second copy is given to the cashier. Cashier prepares the bill in duplicate. Duplicate means the cashier prepares the two copies, one which the guest can take with them and the second which remains with the cashier. So the second copy of the KOT comes to the cashier. Cashier prepares the bill in two and this bill goes to the F&B service area. And the bill and the payment, the amount which is received from the guest, maybe in the form of cash or the card, it comes back to the cashier. Now, if in case it is in the form of cash, the receipted bill along with the remaining changes goes back to the food and beverage service area. Once this process is over, the second KOTs along with the duplicate bill and the summary sheet. You see, three items are there. The second copy of KOT, right, which has given to the cashier, the duplicate bill. Remember, the bills are prepared in two. One is given to the customer and one remains with the cashier, which comes again here to the auditor, and the summary sheet. Summary sheet is a detail. It has the detail of all the sale which has been done by the cashier on that particular day. So the summary of all the sale. So these three things, second copy of KOT, the duplicate bill, as well as the summary sheet, goes from cashier to the control. And the third copy remains with the waiter. Same happens with the dispense bar. If in case there is something which has been ordered, the top copy goes to the dispense bar, the beverage order ticket, and the beverage is being served to the guest in the food and beverage service area. From here, dispense bar, the top copy comes to the control. Second copy again to the cashier, and the bill is given to the food and beverage service area, to the guest at the food and beverage service area. Similarly, the bills and payment come back to the cashier, and cashier give the receipted bill along with the changes, if any, to the guest via waiter. So the second copy of BOT plus any the duplicate bill and the summary sheet goes back to the control, and the last copy remains with the sommelier this time. So this is the total process of triplicate check-in system in a hotel. Now let's understand the duplicate system. This system is implemented in a restaurant than in the restaurant or the hotel. It is more popular in restaurants and cafe, and in this system food order is taken in duplicate. In triplicate we used to have 3 copies. In duplicate we have only 2 copies of KOT. So how this system worked with one copy which is less, let us see. The first copy sent to the kitchen for collecting dishes, as we do in the triplicate system, we follow the same in the duplicate system. After all the dishes written on the KOT are issued to the concerned waiter, the KOT is inserted into a box which is locked. So the same process, all the items are being given to the waiter to be served in the food and beverage service area. So once the waiter serves the food in the food and beverage service area, the KOT is inserted into a box which is locked, and the key is kept in the control office to prevent any malpractices. So you see the first process, the first copy, the process of duplicate system and the triplicate system is same. Right, the waiter takes the order, the first copy is sent to the kitchen for collecting the dish. Once you have collected the dish, then by the concerned waiter, then the first copy goes to the box, the keys of which is kept under the control system so that there cannot be any malpractice. Now second copy is used by the waiter as a mean of reference during service and for making the bill at the end of the service. So this second copy is acting as both second and third copy. So the cashier is preparing the bill by using this second copy, and this is there with the waiter only or as a reference. So in a smaller establishment, now just go through this point very carefully. In some smaller establishment, the duplicate copy is presented as a bill. So you are presenting duplicate copy only as a bill after adding the rates of all the item which has been ordered. So the duplicate copy of the KOT, you write the amount in front of it once the order has been settled, and you present the same to the guest in some smaller establishment. In other establishment, the cashier will prepare the bill with the help of this second copy, and the copy remains with the waiters. So if in case we find the difference in the duplicate and triplicate system, we can further differentiate in 5 major points. The first being type of establishment. In duplicate, it is being practiced in popular in restaurants, cafe, and small hotels, where the table d'hote menu is in operation with possibly a very limited a la carte system, not much a la carte is operated. In triplicate, it is being practiced in first class establishment, usually operating an extensive a la carte menu. So where we have more a la carte menu, we need more control, we have a triplicate system. So where we have further lesser control, if in case you find a difference, you are using a duplicate system. So number of copies, as you know, duplicate, we have 2 copies, triplicate, we have 3 copies. Bill in the duplicate copy of the food check and is made out by the waiter or cashier. So anyone can make the bill in generally duplicate system, the waiter themselves. So they can use the second copy to prepare the bill. Or bill can also be mentioned in the second copy. However, in triplicate, cashier make out the bill which is in duplicate with the help of the second copy. Payment of the bill, the guest may pay the bill directly to the cashier or through the waiter according to the policy of the establishment. So the guest in the duplicate system have the choice. Guest ke paas choice hai. It depends karta what is there in the establishment's house rules. Whether the guest have to come to the cashier point and give the bill, or the waiter will bring the bill to the guest and the guest will pay the amount to the waiter. But in triplicate, the guest have to pay the bill via the waiter. Right, the guest pays the bill to the cashier via the waiter, who returns the receipted bill and change to the guest. So the guest have to pay the bill, but he will not go to the cashier directly. He will give the amount to the waiter, who will then go to the cashier and take the receipted bill from the cashier and will return it back to the guest. So they have this. They have to follow this rule. This is the set rule for triplicate system. So what happened at the end of the service? The sales summary sheet. I told you what a sales summary sheet. The full day sale of the establishment is mentioned. This much amount. This is the price. So all the sales summary sheet. The sales summary sheet along with stubs from the waiter's check. Stub means the last copy, the flexi copy also. Must be handed over to the control together with the cash receipt. So you can have this. The second copy is given for the control purpose. In triplicate, what happened? The sales summary sheet along with duplicate bill and check is handed over to the control department by the cashier. So the second copy goes, and here also the second copy goes in the duplicate system. But in duplicate system, we have only two copies. So in triplicate system, second copy along with the duplicate bill and the check is everything is handed over to the control for the purpose of control. So these are basically five major points: type of establishment, number of copies of food check, the bill, the payment of the bill, that is the method by which you pay the bill, and the process by which you pay the bill, and at the end of the service, how this all this gets transferred to the control or the auditor for the process of checking. So this is what the difference between the duplicate and triplicate system of checking is. Now, some assignment and self-learning and online session. There is a Moodle assignment for you. You have to prepare a flowchart. As you can see that I have already prepared a flowchart for triplicate system. You have to prepare similarly a flowchart for duplicate checking system in MS Word. Now save this file as a PDF with your name and roll number, and you have to upload it as a Moodle assignment. You will find that there is a place to upload an assignment at Moodle assignment, so you have to upload at that place. Now self-learning, you go through this question, what are the different types of QOTs, we have discussed that. And you can find if in case there are any two chargeable QOTs, any two non-chargeable QOTs. So find the answer of these questions if in case you can. And if in case you have any doubt or any question, you can write it in your notebook. And I shall answer the queries in the next online session, with the detail of which will be uploaded in Moodle very soon. So please go through this properly once again if in case you have not understood. Get the answer of these questions. And if in case you have any queries, write it down in the notebook, because then we will come in the online session. You should have this written so that you can ask the question and I can solve the query. So we will be using this online session more now as a question answer session, your query solving session. And I will be uploading more video lectures so that you can go through it and prepare yourself for the question answers in the online session. Thank you very much for joining the session.